All right, you guys, I am super pumped to have our guest speaker today is Ashley Odenweller. She is freaking incredible, like rock star coach. I'm not really sure how we met. Did we meet in Central Region Leaderboard?
Yep.
I think that's where we met. I don't know. She commented that she liked my headband in a Zoom chat, and we just became best friends. So little did I know that she's just like a major rock star. So anyway, Ashley is, okay, I'm going to get my stats up because there are a lot of stats. Rock star. Okay. She is a 4-star diamond in her first business center. Okay, so this is what I'm going to explain to you, because just in case you don't know this. Once you become a 2-star diamond, you get to personally sponsor yourself as a coach and open another business center. Okay, so she is a 4-star diamond in her first business center, a 2-star diamond in her second business center. Her husband is a 2-star, right? And they have 2 other CBCs together. So what, 5 business centers all together? Is that right? She has 5 business centers. Holy cannoli, rock star. Okay. She's also a Success Club 5 All-Star Legend. She's a 2015 Premier Coach. And yeah, rock star. And to get this, she's done it all on her own. She has no upline support. She is just a freaking rock star. So I am going to turn the time over to her. She is going to talk to us about how she's done this and how she became her own CEO. So I'm going to just stop talking and let you run with it.
All right. Well, hey guys, thanks for having me. Thanks for coming in the morning, afternoon, wherever you may be. So I'm going to share my story really quickly, and then I'm going to dive in. I have 5 tips for you guys today. So before I like dive into my Beachbody story, I always like to let people know, like, some people think like you're successful because you had success growing up, and I'm like the complete opposite. So if you follow me on Facebook, you might have already heard the story, but like we grew up with 0 money. Like I come home from school, electricity's off, water's off, no groceries. I'm like, oh, this is cool. Like this is awesome. But that was what I was used to. I was used to not having electricity and water almost every other month. I was used to going through the McDonald's drive-thru line because my mom thought we could only afford the dollar menu instead of going to the store. Like that's what I grew up knowing. I shouldn't have graduated from high school. I had a teacher that loved me, luckily, and was like, you know what? I'm going to give you a D instead of an F so you can actually graduate high school. I dropped out of college 3 times until I finally finished and got my degree when I was 24 years old. Like, I am the poster child or poster person that should not be successful, that should have fallen flat on her face and not done anything with her life. But I chose to do something with my life because I know that I could do something with my life. So I started Beachbody in 2012. I didn't become a coach until 2013. My husband found Turbo Fire, fell in love, started the program, lost 40 pounds with it, ended up losing another 10 with less muscle pump and whatnot. My coach nagged me for an entire year and asked me to become a coach. And I said no for an entire year. It's like, I don't have time for this. I don't know what this is about. I'm good. Like I don't have time. She finally asked me one more time and I was like, fine, whatever, I'll do it. And only because she paid my $40 fee. I didn't buy a challenge pack. I didn't buy Shakeology. She paid my $40 fee and that's the only reason I signed up. I was like, I have absolutely nothing to lose. I didn't get Shakeology for the first couple months as a coach because I couldn't afford it. I was the person that bought Shakeology and my programs off Amazon and eBay because that's what I thought you did. Like I didn't know any better. So I decided if I was going to try this coaching thing, I was going to go all in. And at the time I was a full-time student taking 6 out classes. I was in my senior year. So like, that was like probably the one of the more stressful semesters, like finishing everything up. I was doing a 20-hour internship. I was working full-time 40 hours a week. I was planning a wedding and I was commuting 2 hours, 5 days a week. So when people say they don't have time to work the business, I'm like, nope. Like I don't want to hear it. And you'll learn I don't like excuses. Like, that's not my thing. So I decided I was going to go all in, and I did. I started running challenge groups right away. I hit Emerald in my first 3 months of the business. I hit Success Club every single month. I hit Diamond by my 7th month as a coach. And then we moved from Ohio to Rochester, and I became a retail manager. My background is in social work. That is what my degree is in, but I went with retail management because why not? Giving your life away to people who are really rude every single day is exactly what I wanted to do with my life. And that's what I did. And my business completely plummeted. I went from a solid diamond to a barely shaky emerald. I went to my coach and said, you know what? I'm done. Like, I can't do this anymore. I'm too busy at work. I was in charge of like visuals and ads and sales for Black Friday. And that's a lot of pressure when you work for a big box store. And she told me to stay on and just keep getting my discount because I did drink Shakeology every single day. I was like, fine, whatever, I'll stay. January of 2014, I had one success club point. February of 2014, I ended the month with 87 success club points. I did a complete 360 and decided that enough was enough and that I could work this business. I was homesick from surgery. My phone was going off 24/7 and I couldn't even like get better because I was so stressed. So I decided to go all in. And we ended, I like to always say this. So in March of 2014, I had about seven coaches on my team. We ended 2014 as a two-star premier team with over 250 coaches on our team. We did like a complete 360 and I just decided I was all in. I ended up quitting my job in September of 2014. My husband and I decided to sell our house and quit his job in New York and move back to Ohio last October. And now we both do this full time. I'm not a top 10 coach. I'm not a 15-star diamond coach. I will never be a 15-star diamond coach. And I'm okay with that because I do have five business centers. And that is where I'm at because that's what's going to create financial freedom for me and my husband. If you want to be a 15-star? Great. Go for it. Don't let that stop you. But that's who I am. I will never be considered the most successful coach in this business, and I am okay with that. But I am creating a future for my family and I am creating financial freedom and living my life by design. My husband and I can literally leave and go grocery shopping at 11 o'clock in the afternoon on a Tuesday if we want to and not worry about a 9-to-5 job. Now, I did this all on my own. Yes, I have an upline. But she is, and she'll say she wasn't there for me. She didn't know how to help me grow. She didn't expect me to become the coach that I've become. I wasn't in trainings. I didn't have one-on-one calls. I didn't have team calls. I didn't have any of that stuff. But I decided that I wasn't going to use that as an excuse to not rock my business. So I'm going to give you guys five tips today on being your own CEO. I'm going to be very honest with you. I'm blunt. I curse sometimes and I tell it like it is. I don't sugarcoat things and I don't coddle people. My team pretty much hates me half the time because I'm like a tough love mama bear. So the first thing is you need to quit blaming others for your non-success. This is your business. You are the boss of your business. It's not your upline's fault that you didn't hit Success Club 5. It's not your upline's fault that you dropped your rank. It's not your upline's fault that you've been trying to hit the same goal for the last 5 months. That's your fault. That's because you're not honing in on what you need to be doing. I always tell my coaches that they're like, well, I've been trying to hit the same goal for 5 months. Are you doing personal development? Probably not. Are you inviting? Probably not. Are you doing being proof of the product? You probably are because we're always proof of the products. That's the easiest. But half the time we don't want to invite because it's a scary thing that nobody wants to do. And we're like, we don't need those self-help books. We're good. First 3 years of my business, I did not do personal development. I was like, I don't need this. I don't need self-help. Like, I'm good. I'm on my own. The minute I started doing personal development, my business did a 360 and I noticed a huge change in me and my team and in my leadership style. So if you're not happy with where you're at, you need to decide. You just need to do it. You can't quit blaming other people. Your success depends on you and what you do with this business. No one's going to hold your hand through this. And if they do, they're only hindering you further on. I don't hold my coaches' hands because when it's time for them to lead their own team, I have only enabled them to come back to me, find the answers, and let their coaches know instead of taking that ownership. So you have to take ownership of your own business. Number two, don't ask for the answers. Find them yourself. Nothing irritates me more than when a coach comes to me and they're like, what's the club membership fee? And I'm like, no, FAQ. Or my favorite was, is what's your coach monthly fee? First off, you get charged that every month. You should know what your coach monthly fee is. Secondly, we have the resources. I always like to think of it. Would you go to your boss or your teacher and say, hey, I can't find this answer. Can you tell me what it is? First off, your boss would probably laugh at you in the face and say, get your shit together and go figure it out yourself. Or your teacher would be like, you're hilarious. I'm not giving you the answer. This is your business. It should be the same exact way. We have the FAQ. That thing is like one of the most amazing resources ever. And if you can't find the answer, then go to Google. And I know it sounds weird when I say Google, but there are so many resources out there from other coaches like Katie Hefner, Scotty Hobbs, Lindsay Matway, Lindsay Stalick. All these coaches have websites and resources that you can find these answers. Next, go to your team page. I don't know if you guys know this, but when you're on your mobile app, like in the Facebook, you can search, if you're in the group, search and say, in this group, chances are somebody's already asked this question. So look for it in the TMH. And if you can't find in those three, then go to your upline. You should never be going to your upline unless you have found these three questions. And the reason I say this is because you need to learn this on your own so you can help your team. I never bothered my upline with questions. I checked the FAQ. I learned about legs. I learned about placement. I learned about cycle bonus. I did this all on my team and being a better team and not being needy on me, if that's the right word. So quit asking for the answers and just find them yourselves. I promise they're really easy to find. Like, I'm in the central region page with Michaela, and it drives me nuts when someone's like, how many success club points do I get for a customer? And I'm like, FAQ. I'm like, it's right there. And then they argue with me that that's not the correct answer, even though I gave them the answer. Drives me nuts. So find the answers yourself. Number three, you have to lead by example. I preach to my team about hitting success club. I've hit success club for the last 27 months in a row. If I wasn't hitting success club, then I could not preach to my team about hitting success club. I have diamonds in my downline that are like, you have to hit success club. And I'm like, you yourself have not hit success club in months. Your team is not going to hit success club if you're not doing the same thing. If you want your coaches to be doing the three vital behaviors, guess what? You better be doing them. If you want your coaches to be filling out their BAT, guess what? You need to be doing them. If you're seeing that your coaches aren't adding coaches to the team, you need to do a reality check and ask yourself, am I adding coaches as well? Your team will follow by the example that you lead. I don't know if that sentence made any sense, but we're going to run with it. I can't expect my team to do things that I'm not doing. If I want my team to hit success club, I'm going to hit success club. If I want my team to be on team calls, I'm going to be on team calls. You have to be lead by example. They are watching you without a doubt. They're checking your posts. They're reading what you're saying. They're seeing your negative posts and like, well, if she can be negative, I can be negative. I have really shitty days, like days where like I don't want to do anything, but you better believe I show up at my team page and I am there showing them that I'm active. I am not posting on Facebook how much I hate politics and Donald Trump and that these cramps are killing me. I am positive. I make sure people see what I'm doing. And I lead my team by example. But you've got to do that. If you want your coaches to do something, you better be doing the same darn thing. Number four, create the same success for your team. So what do I mean by that? I could have grown my team and just said, you know what? I'm good. I'm not helping my coaches. Like, I don't have time for that. No, I show up. I do one-on-one calls. I do getting started right calls. I make sure that our trainings are like clockwork. I make sure that our team calls are like clockwork. I never cancel a team call. Even if I'm like dying on my deathbed, I am still present on my team calls. Why? Because this is how I was successful, and that's how I'm showing my team to be successful. I give them the resources that they need. I make sure that they're in the trainings. I make sure that they can duplicate the trainings. Teach your coaches the same exact thing. Duplicate, duplicate, duplicate. That's really what it comes down to. I see too many people trying to reinvent the wheel, and they're like, well, I got to do this, 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 and this. So why would you spend your time trying to recreate the wheel? Instead, use what's already put in front of you. So you got to create that same success for your team. And the last one is my favorite. Get past the damn excuses and the fear. I was on a call last night and we talked about fear. Fear is the number one thing that holds us back. Think about it. We don't invite because we're fearful of what other people are going to think. We don't put out our before and afters because we're afraid of what other people are going to think. The longer you let that fear stand in front of you, the longer that fear dictates your future. I could have been terrified that I would suck at this business and never did anything with it. And if I would have done that, I would probably still be in New York, hating my life, working 40-something hours a week, and dealing with snippety teenagers because I worked at Aerie. And that's what I dealt with day in and day out. But instead, I decided to put that fear behind me and go all in and go after I wanted. I quit with the excuses of no one's liking my Facebook post, the excuses of no one's answering my Facebook message. Well, so-and-so said she was going to sign up, and then she never signed up. Well, I had a lead, but Beachbody made it fraud. Lead and now it's a return and now I'm negative PV. Like, those are excuses and those are fears, and you have to get past those. If you keep those excuses and those keep those fears up, but you will never be successful. Do it, Yes, because that's how I grow. That's how I have 5 CDCs. That's how I have 120 plus personally sponsored coaches underneath me. Because I got past my fears and I got past my excuses and I did the work that needed to be done to be successful in this business. You have to decide how bad you want this. And you have to decide the sacrifices that you're going to make in order for this to happen. And I know that sacrifice word is like really scary. People are like, well, I don't want to give up grades, or I don't want to give up scandal, or I just want to lay in bed today. Well, guess what? You put in the work now, you can lay in bed later. I put in the work. So now when I am like dying from like Shark Week and on the couch dying from cramps, guess what? I can spend an entire day binge watching CSI because I have already created that success. And I know that on Thursday, I'm still going to have one good of a paycheck because I've created that success because I quit letting those excuses happen. I was the person that worked full time. I was the person that was probably answering messages while I was going to the bathroom. And nobody can say they don't do that because we all do that. I squeezed in time on my, yep, see, yeah, I'm not alone. If you've messaged me before, I was probably going to the bathroom answering your message. It's all about time management and making it work. I was staying up later. I was waking up earlier. I would spend my entire lunch break answering calls, inviting to challenge groups. I made the sacrifices that way later on in life. I didn't have to worry about it. Like last Wednesday, it was a beautiful day here. My husband and I went to the zoo with our niece and nephew. I wouldn't have been able to do that 2 years ago because I would have been working and also 10 hours away in New York. But I made the sacrifices. I got past the excuses and I quit letting the reason of my biggest reason for a long time was I don't have upline support. Who gives a shit? You guys obviously have upline support because you're on this call. But my coach has never held a team call for me. When, and hopefully she never finds this recording, when I hit one star, it was, oh, look at this coach. She hit one star. Great job. Like one sentence. When I hit 4 star, I had to let her know that I hit 4 star. When I hit 2 star in my second CBC, I had to message her that and be like, hey, did you see that I ranked up today? I just thought I'd let you know. Like that's the support that I get. But I didn't let that hold me back. I went after what I wanted because at the end of the day, this business has so much opportunity and so many doors that can open for you. But you have to decide if you want it and if you're going to make those sacrifices. So that's it. Those are my 5 tips. I would love to answer any questions if anybody has any. I kind of talk really quickly. I apologize.
No, rocking. Does anyone have any questions? Anybody? Type it in the chat. Anybody? Or just shake your head so I can know.
If you're like,
or you can private message
ask questions.
And I'll send it. Okay, well, preach right there. Like everyone just needs, Ashley just needs to like drop her mic and like walk away. Like I think that would be the perfect ending to this call because I feel like everybody needs to hear this. Like I'm going to be like, I don't know. You're probably going to have a post in the central region like telling everyone they need you. So just so you know, because that was amazing because it's so true. And I just, I don't know. Whew, I loved it. I don't think I can add anything to it because, well, it's amazing. So I just want to thank Ashley for taking time out to do this call for us. I know she's busy. Like she says, she has a rocking team and she's leading a powerhouse business. And I am just so grateful for her for jumping on and talking to you guys. So feel free to go show her some love on her page because she's amazing. And if you have any questions, let me know and I will ask her. Make sure if your coaches weren't on this call that they listen to this recording. I feel like this is a non-negotiable call. This needs to be heard by everybody. So thank you for taking time out of your day. I will be sure I'll be chatting with you later. But have a great day, everyone.
Thanks for having me. Bye, guys.